the literature on decoloniality raises important questions about Western systems of knowledge and asks us to think other from the perspective of the subaltern colonial. And so I think from this perspective, one might see home language as a Western construct linked to notions of a monolingual nation state. A separate bounded language is not the language spoken by urban children, at least in Gauteng. Many South African kids learn literacy in a language that they do not speak properly without an oral base, and many are expected to switch to literacy in a non-cognate language before they can read and write in any language. And I think that's one of the problems, those are some of the problems we're dealing with. Oh, look. I think we agree about a lot. I think if you made a list of all the things we agree about a lot. What we don't agree about is the balance between skills, small space and big space, as you're talking about, between skills and meaning. We don't agree on what should be emphasized. We don't agree on order and sequencing. What should come first? I mean, people think reading should come before writing. I would want to argue that writing and encoding is the ways in which children understand what literacy is for. So, you know, whether you can do meaning before you've done decoding, those are ordering and sequencing issues. I don't think we agree about the balance of talk, listening, reading, and writing, and the way they are all important for learning to read. I don't think we agree about the necessity for teachers to have repertoires of pedagogies for teaching literacy. And I don't think we agree about children. So I think we constantly underestimate children. We don't see them as curious questioners who are able to make meaning and ask interesting questions. The quote on the right is something that I think you can all decode. I would like somebody to tell me what they think it means. Okay, that's my example of that. And I think in terms of social practices, we need to see phonics drills as much as a sociocultural practice, as much as sending a text message or writing your name on a book. They are all social practices. Some of them engage students in learning, in enjoying reading, some of them don't. And I think that part of what kids have to get is that literacy is tied to different social purposes. This model of the Free Bodies and Luke's model is a theoretical model designed to draw in the best practices from different orientations to literacy education. And I think we ignore them at our peril. We do the first two to an extent, although I don't think we always take the participant role of reading seriously. The kids have to take meaning from text and bring meaning to text. I think we need to think about the kinds of texts that kids learn to read. And I think we have to work with helping teachers to ask kids higher order questions about what they're reading. Why? What matters? Why is this important? How are girls presented here? And this is what I want to tell the president, okay? And some of the things here have occurred on previous slides. We need smaller classes. In Lithuania, they split a literacy class. Half goes to maths numeracy, half goes to literacy. Then they switch around to make for different size classes. We need multilingual reading materials, and I would argue that we need a literacy specialist in every school. Every HOD should have a repertoire for teaching literacy, because not all kids learn in the same way. And if you're going to script kids, there has to be somebody in the school who knows how, script teachers, how to expand beyond that so that they can cope with kids who don't actually work in the ways that the script says. And just finally, we do have to pay attention to adult literacy.